Yom Kippur, the day of forgiveness. To a very great extent, this is truly the happiest day of the Jewish calendar. What it teaches us is that our God is a God of forgiveness. Our God is a God of love. In the prayers of forgivenesses, the Slichot, we repeat again and again the 13 names of God from the book of Exodus, chapter 34. Hashem, Hashem, kel rachum v'chanun. The Lord is a God of compassion. Bashem kaperno. And when the high priest asks forgiveness of the Jewish people, he says, by means of your name, God, forgive us, please. And Yud Hei Vav Hei, the name of God, the ineffable name of God, that name means love. It means complete love. It means love without any questions or ifs, ands, and buts. It means love no matter what. It's repeated twice, and our sages interpret, I am Hashem, the God who loves you before you sin, and I am Hashem, the God who loves you after you sin. And therefore we repeat that again and again to sort of tell ourselves and perhaps even remind God that He loves us and He takes us and He accepts us as long as we come to Him in repentance and admit that we're sorry for our sins. There's an amazing repartee between Rav Menachem Mendel of Kotsk, the Kotsk Rebbe, and his disciples. The disciples of the Kotsk Rebbe said, how come within the Hasidic ethos, God is almost constantly described by the name Shekhinah, the divine presence? And Shekhinah is a feminine noun. It concludes with Kamatzei, which is the sign of feminism. Yeled is a boy child. Yalda is a girl child. Shekhinah is a feminine noun. Why do we, a patriarchal society, ask the students of the Kotsker, refer to God in feminine terms? The Kotsker smiled. He said, look at the next words. Hashem, Hashem, kel rachum v'chanun. Rachum is usually translated as compassionate. But you know, rachum is based upon a smaller word, a smaller noun, Rechem, which means womb. How does God love us? Just like the mother who loves the baby, the fetus, the newborn child who emerges from her womb. The Kotsker Rebbe asked his disciples, did you ever see a mother change a baby's diaper? How she kisses the baby as she is cleaning and cleansing the baby? The mother who loves her baby with all his poo, with all the mess in the diaper. Because the baby is, after all, an indelible and inextricable part of herself. We were all born from the womb of the divine. We are all God's children, siblings with each other, recipients of DNA, a divine natural association which links us together because we're all created from God's womb in God's image. And God loves us just as the mother loves her child, because we are an indelible part of Him. And He accepts us lovingly with all of our mess and with all of our dirt. And if we only ask Him to, He'll give us the strength to cleanse ourselves. That's an amazing message. A message that must fill everyone with great joy. And that's what makes Yom Kippur the happiest day of the year. Shana tova u'metuka, a very good and sweet year.